Hello, everyone. Good evening. Welcome to the class. Hello, Rafael, Antonio.
Hello.
Katia, hi.
Hello.
Nice to see you again. Hello, everyone. Good evening. Welcome. Guys, if it's possible, can you please activate your cameras? Please activate your cameras. Nehemias. Nice to see you, Nehemias.
Thank you.
How was the vacation? ¿Qué tal estuvo la vacación?
Relax.
Relax. Okay. Well, nice to see you, Nehemias. Hello, Rina. Nice to meet you, Rosy. And René. René Guardado. Okay, so guys, welcome to the class. For the ones who were with me, you know my name. But Rafael, Rosy, Rina, and René, my name is Evelyn, Evelyn Marinero. And I'm going to be with you in the next module. Okay, so if you need me, let me know. Así que si me necesitan cualquier cosa, pues ahí tenemos el grupo. Por cierto, hablando del grupo, solo tengo como a seis o siete están en el grupo. Todos ustedes acá ya están. Nehemías, creo que sí, ¿verdad? Creo que ahí lo vi. Katia.
También.
Uh-huh. Rosy, Rina. Ya están en el grupo.
Creo.
Rina, no. Rina, y ahorita está utilizando su celular.
Sí, tengo problemas con la compu, pero ya ahorita estoy en eso.
Ok, allí en el chat mandé el link que es para el grupo de WhatsApp. Si le da clic, la va a agregar al grupo. Ok, so you can.
You can ahorita.
Ok, guys, I'm going to take the attendance. I'm going to take the attendance first of all, and then we start. Okay, so remember to say present. Remember to say present. So Daisy Mezquita, Doris Guevara, Iris Joana, Jennifer Marcela, Katia Gabriela.
Present.
Thank you. Lisette del Carmen. Mauricio Castaneda. Minet Rivera. Nehemías Regalo.
Present.
Thank you. Nelson Aguirre. Nelson Alberto Aguirre. No. Nelson René Guevara. Rafael Antonio Barrientos.
Present.
Thank you. René Guardado.
Present.
Rina Espinosa.
Present, teacher.
Rosy Meléndez.
Present.
Thank you. Vladimir Rodas. Yanira Cepeda.
Present, teacher.
Hi, Yanni. Welcome.
Hi, nice to teacher. See
you. Welcome. Yes. Okay, Yanni. And the last one, Zulma Lorena López. Zulma is not here. Okay, so guys, before we start the class, we have to go over some points that we have to remember. Antes que comencemos, hay unos puntos que siempre vamos a tocar al inicio del módulo. So I'm just going to share this with you and then we will talk about it. One moment. Okay. So as you know, we have studied level number 2, module 2. Acabamos de iniciar el módulo número 2 and we have some information. Como se recuerdan, acá está mi información de mi formación académica, cómo aprendí inglés, donde he trabajado, so you can see where what I have done. Okay, I learned English here in Ithaca and in the United States in Redmond. I study in college there. I got my TOEIC certification and I have my INSAFORT certification as well. And experiencia laboral, you can see what I have been doing. I work at a call center for about 3 years. Trabajé en un call center en Sykes. Muchos de seguro lo conocen, alrededor de 3 años. Trabajo con Academia Europea también desde el 2016. En INSAFORT online since last year. Desde que empezó la pandemia con INSAFORT en línea. Okay, so this is a little bit about me. And now, requerimientos, okay, about you. Nehemías, can you read, please, the information?
Okay. Requerimientos. Nombre completo al conectarse a la plataforma. En el caso de oyentes, agregar palabra oyente luego de su nombre. Cámara encendida durante toda la sesión. Minimizar el sonido ambiente lo más posible. Participación activa.
Okay, thank you. So here you have some requirements. Aquí tienen lo que pedimos de ustedes, ¿verdad? Recuerden siempre tener su nombre completo para que se pueda encontrar, ¿verdad? Su puntaje y su porcentaje de tiempo en la clase. También recuerden la cámara de mantenerla activada. Yo sé que a veces por alguna razón tal vez no la van a poder activar. Send me a message. Por favor, déjenmelo saber cuando es así. And your participation is also important. Do you have questions about this point? No sé si tienen alguna duda sobre estos puntos.
Good evening, teacher.
Yes, hello.
Not really, but on my case, I have a situation with my phone. That's why okay. I don't have camera right now, but pretty much by tomorrow, I will be able to use it.
Okay, so
that's
thank
why
you.
Just for today, I don't gonna have.
Thank camera. You very much for letting me know, Rene. Now I'm aware. Okay, thank you. No Perfect. Problem. Okay, let's continue. Now, asistencia. This is an important point. Katia, can you read it, please? Can you read those points?
Sería asistencia 100% de las clases. La asistencia no solamente se toma al estar presente, sino también a cumplir con la clase completa. La asistencia se toma en 3 ocasiones, 8, 9 y 9.55 p.m. Se tomará como válida al escuchar la parte. La participante.
Al participante.
Al participante decir presente o presente y tener la cámara encendida.
Ajá.
Sesiones de 1 a 1 disponibles. Cada participante será asignado 10 minutos al finalizar la clase para aclarar las dudas con el facilitador. Permisos no disponibles.
Okay, thank you, Katia. So let's talk about this. INSAFORT, sobre su asistencia. INSAFORT pide 80% de su asistencia. Y yo sé que a veces hay emergencias, enfermedades, trabajo extra, y ya me han escrito, ¿verdad?, para informarme o pedirme permiso. Lamentablemente, nosotros como inglés corporativo o yo como facilitadora no puedo concederles ese permiso. INSAFOR también comprende eso. Por eso el porcentaje es 80%. Así que cuídenlo. Traten de siempre, ¿verdad?, no faltar a sus clases, conectarse a tiempo. Y utilicen ese porcentaje pequeño que tienen cuando tengan esa emergencia, ¿verdad? Porque es 80%, creo que también en el grupo se les envió 80%, pero traten de utilizarlo en caso de emergencia, porque no sabemos qué trae el día siguiente, así que si en ese día no pueden, pues ahí tienen ese pequeño chance, ¿verdad? Pero sí, traten de no faltar, porque les va a afectar en su aprendizaje. Do you have questions about this point? ¿Preguntas, dudas sobre asistencia? No. Okay. Next. Let's continue with that one. Rosie, can you read, please? Can you read the information?
Okay. Tareas y evaluaciones. Es necesario obtener el 80% en promedio de tareas y evaluaciones para poder completar el curso satisfactoriamente. Las tareas se encuentran en la plataforma, justo después de cada clase. Todas las tareas de los temas ya cubiertos tienen que estar completas antes de cada viernes a la medianoche, ya que ese registro es enviado a INSAFOR semanalmente. La fecha límite para terminar el examen medio, midterm, es el miércoles 1 de septiembre antes de la medianoche. La fecha límite para terminar el examen final, final exam, es el jueves 16 de septiembre antes de la medianoche. El manual puede ser descargado de la plataforma. No se utiliza material de terceros en ninguna sesión.
Mm-hmm. Ok, thank you, Rosie. So, tareas y evaluaciones. Recuerden la plataforma, si alguien tiene problemas para accesar, por favor avísennos, porque ustedes saben de que tienen que terminar, tienen que completar todas las tareas para que puedan terminar y completar el curso. Así que traten, yo siempre les voy a estar recordando, acá tienen las fechas límites para cada uno de los, bueno, para el midterm test y para el final test. Acá están las fechas. Y recuerden que siempre hay una tarea diaria, cada sección. Ahora, como empezamos el día jueves, prácticamente el día miércoles terminamos la unidad 1. Así que ese día tendrían que terminar section 1, ¿verdad? So, if you need help, si tienen problemas para entrar a la plataforma, please let us know. Okay, is this part clear? ¿Estamos claros acá? Yes, okay, great. Excellent. And Zoom, most of you already have experience, right? Yo creo que ya casi que todos ya tienen experiencia en cómo utilizar Zoom, pero acá tenemos recordatorios, reminders. Tienen el botón para silenciarse ustedes mismos. Usualmente yo lo silencio luego de su comentario por el background noise, por el sonido a veces que da, ¿verdad? Así que usualmente yo lo hago, pero ustedes también lo pueden hacer. So you have the camera icon, the chat, breakout rooms, que son los que utilizamos, ¿verdad? Para trabajar en diferentes actividades. Y cuando están en esos breakout rooms, también tienen esta opción, ask for help. Y si ustedes lo presionan, pues yo ahí puedo. Me notifica Zoom y yo ya puedo llegar ahí. Ok. So that's it, guys. Do you have questions? Questions about that? About any of the points that we talk about? No. No questions. Ok, well, nice to have you here, guys. Hi, Nelson. Welcome. Nice to see you. Hello, Daisy. Todos como que fuera ayer, ¿verdad? Ya pasaron como dos semanas. Va volando el tiempo. So, guys, in that case, we will start. We will go ahead and start the class. Okay. Vamos a comenzar ya. Today, it's going to be like a review. Okay, we're going to refresh what we studied in the last level. Va a ser como un recordatorio de lo que estuvimos estudiando el módulo pasado para recordar, right? Verbs, simple present, and things like that. Okay, I'm going to share the book. I'm going to share the book. And we will start here. One moment. Okay, can you see it? Do you see the screen? ¿Sí logran ver? Yes, okay. All right, so we start with Nelson. Nelson, number one, question number one. What are three things you do on Mondays, Nelson? The microphone, Nelson. Three things, the first three things you do on Mondays. Las primeras tres cosas que hace on Mondays. Three things.
Okay. I take a shower. I work. I brush my teeth.
And you brush my your teeth. Good, you remember. That's nice. Okay, thank you. And Rafael, Rafa, do you like to be called Rafael or Antonio? What do you prefer?
Rafael.
Rafa, okay, Rafa. What about you? What are the first three things you do on Mondays?
I get up at 5 a.m.
Wow.
I take a shower. I watch the news.
And you watch the news. Really? Very early in the morning.
Yes.
Okay, Rafa, thank you. Gianni, and you? What are the first three things you do on Mondays? You'll receive the notification, Gianni, to activate the microphone. Gianni? Gianni, it's not there. René, and you?
Well, Mondays, I think that is the on a busy day for me. I start to make my agenda for the entire week. Well, I wake up, I take a shower, then I start to work really early because I start to work around 5 a.m. in the morning.
Wow, you start to work at 5, or you
at 5, that's right,
wake up. Wow.
No, I wake up at 4:30 a.m. Mm-hmm. And I start to work at 5. Mm-hmm. So
how do you feel in this moment? Do you feel tired, sleepy?
And not really. I get used to it, to sleep like less than 6 hours a day, and work pretty much all the day.
Wow.
Right now I am on vacation, so pretty much.
That's cool.
I rest enough now. I I wake up around 7 a.m. all these days, so pretty much it's a lot of the sleep.
It's relaxing in comparison to the time you usually wake up. That's cool.
That's right.
Okay, René, thank you for your comment.
Sure.
Gianni. Hoy sí, Gianni.
Teacher, no me pasó algo que me regresó para registrarme en Zoom, pero también tengo una pantalla negra.
Okay, let me refresh. And now, can you see it?
Okay.
I see. So this is the question, Gianni. What are the first three things you do on Mondays? What can you tell us about that?
I have 6 a.m.
You wake up at 6, 6 a.m.
The car, my work.
You drive to work.
My girl.
You drive. Okay. And number three?
I am bread.
I eat breakfast.
I am at 8 a.m.
There you go, Jani. Thank you. Okay, hoy es el primer día. Ahora no sé si les pasa a ustedes después que no han practicado inglés, se siente raro como volver a usarlo, como que la lengua y todo se siente así como que raro. So, today is the first day. Así que vamos a refrescar, todo va a empezar a regresar. Okay, Jani. Thank you. Thank you for your comment. Now, Rina, how many times do you check your email? ¿Cuántas veces? How many times? One time, two times. How many times?
One time.
You have two options to say one time. You can say one time or once. There are two possibilities. For example, I check my email one time a day, for example. And you, Rina, only one time a day.
Only one, I think.
Ah, poquito. No es mucho, but it's every day.
Casi no lo reviso. Casi.
No. You don't receive important information by email. No le mandan información importante.
No.
Okay. All right. So, yes, guys, you can say one time, two times, to talk about the repetition of the activity, right? One time, a day, a week, a month, etc. To say two times, there are two options. You can say two times or twice is the same. Twice and two times are the same, son lo mismo. You have two possibilities. One time or once, también son lo mismo. Una vez, dos veces, etc. Okay, let's see. Daisy Yesenia, hi. Which name do you prefer, Daisy or Yesenia?
Daisy.
Sí. Okay, Daisy. How many times a day do you check your mail?
One time.
A day? A week?
Yes.
Why? Why only one? One time.
¿Por qué una vez?
Uh-huh.
Igual casi no recibo así información importante.
Where do you work, Daisy?
Trabajo en una farmacia.
Ah, okay, en una farmacia. Uh-huh. But you don't use your email too much. Casi no lo utilizan el email.
No, como el trato es más que todo directo, así con el cliente.
Customers. Okay, Daisy. Well, thank you for telling us. And let's see, Nehemias. Nehemias, what about you? How many times a day do you check your email?
Very much time.
How many? A lot. Many times.
Many times.
Wow. Why?
Todo lo manejo con correos. Mm-hmm. La mayoría de cosas de mi trabajo son correos.
Ah, okay. It's necessary for you. How often would you say? ¿Cada cuánto sería? Every hour? Every morning? All the time?
Cuando me notifica el...
when you receive the notification.
Yes.
So you receive the notification y ya. Ya rápido lo va a revisar.
Yes.
Okay. That's a lot. Okay. Thank you. Let me see. Well, guys, we will continue. We will continue here. But give me... just check something here. Okay, we will continue here. Please listen to the pronunciation. Listen to the pronunciation and then it will be your turn. Sofia and Mario, what do you do every Monday morning? I check my email and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you? I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meetings every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day? Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day. Great. It is very important. Okay, so now it will be your turn. We will start with Katia and Rosy. Okay, Katia. Give me one second, Katia. Just give me one moment. Let me check something here really quick. Okay, Katia, you are Sofia. And Rosy, Mario.
Okay.
What
do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meetings every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great. It is very important.
Very good pronunciation. Thank you, Katia. Thank you, Rosy. Now, Nelson and Rafael. Nelson, you are Sofia, and Rafa, Mario.
Okay.
You are Sophie.
Okay. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a mirror, and also have to organize a mirror every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Read. It is very important.
Okay, Nelson, thank you. And thank you, Rafa. Just this one here is clients. That is the correct pronunciation. Clients. Yeah. And this one here, actually. Actually. That's the way it sounds.
I check it once. One or twice.
Once or twice. Yes, that's the way it sounds.
Thank you.
Okay, guys. You're welcome. Now, Jenny. Jenny and René. Jenny, you are Sofia. René, Mario.
Okay. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my emails and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I had to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also had to organize meeting every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great. Is it very important?
Okay, thank you very much, Jenny and René. Jenny, I'm going to help you with some words, okay? Please repeat after me. Weekly.
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 Weekly. This weekly. One, organize.
Organize.
Organize, yeah. And this one here in the middle.
Meeting.
Meeting. It sounds meeting. Like R. Suena como R. Meeting. Meeting.
Meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Meeting.
Okay, so okay. Please do it one more time. Number one. We. Can
weekly.
You? Next.
Meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Organize.
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 Yes, there you go. Okay, guys. Thank you. Daisy and Rina. Daisy. Sofia, Rina, Mario.
Okay. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meeting every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. Check I once or twice a day.
Great, it is very important.
Okay, thank you, Rina and Daisy. I will help you with the pronunciation, okay, of some words. I'm just going to highlight them. Okay, one moment. Okay, so let's go with this one. So Rina and Daisy, please repeat after me. Report. Report. Daisy?
Report.
It sounds like the stress, it goes like here. Como que tuviera acento. Report. Ahí está el stress. Ok, email.
Email.
Yes. Once. Twice. Great. Yes. Thank you very much. And Nehemías, we will continue with you. Nehemías and Jani again. But we will switch. Nehemías, you are Sofía. And Jani, you are Mario.
Okay.
Bye. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my emails and call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to
organize
meeting every 2 Mondays. Mm-hmm. How often do you check your email? Your email, do you check it every day?
Yes, I do. Actually, check it once on the try a day.
Right. It is very important.
Thank you, Nehemías, and thank you, Jani. Guys, do you have questions about the vocabulary? Did you find new words? Is there something I can help you with? Conversation, words?
Yo tengo una.
Ajá, and then Jani. Which
often,
one?
Often sería como después.
No, I will try to. It's a compound word. It's a compound word. How often? I will tell you in English and then you let me know if you get me. Okay, so how often is a word that we use in questions? When we want to know about the frequency or the regularity of activities. When you want to know about the regularity of activities, we use how often. What did you understand, Katia?
La frecuencia y lo que yo entendí fue que cada cuánto uno hace.
Exacto. Ajá. There you go. Es para saber la frecuencia de algo. Si yo digo, how often do you take a shower? Estoy pidiendo la frecuencia de esa acción. Ya tú me dices, oh, every day, once a day, y ahí va. Vamos a estudiar eso más adelante. But yes, Katy, that is what it means. Jani, did you have a question?
A teacher, sí, entiendo que dice que cada cuánto se leen los reportes. Solo tengo una duda en la pronunciación de once, lo que es once.
Ah, once.
Ah, se pronuncia once.
Ajá.
Once.
Uh-huh. That's the way it sounds. We're fine.
Donde dice Mario?
Yes.
Or, ¿cómo se pronuncia T-W-I-C?
Twice.
Mm-hmm.
Twice.
Okay.
That's it. Okay. Other questions? Nelson, Rosie, questions? Rina, Rafa? No? No questions. Okay. We have questions about the conversation. Let's see. Okay. Katia, number one, Katia. What activities do Mario and Sofia do on Mondays? What activities do they do on Mondays, Katia?
Check the email.
They? They check?
Check the email. And... Pero solo Sofía read a weekly report.
Just Sophie. Read. Okay. But it's together. It's together. Okay. So yeah, we can okay. say that they check emails. And
read the weekly reports and attend a meeting in an organized meeting.
They attend meetings. And organize meetings. That is what they do. Okay, thank you, Katia. And then, Rosie, do you consider, this question goes for Rosie, Nelson, and Rafa. Question number two, do you consider that it is important to check your email every day? Why do you consider that it is important to check your email every day? Is it important? And guys, if you also want to tell me, you can send it by chat. Los demás, si quisieran comentarlo, me lo pueden enviar en un private message, okay? And I read you. So, Rosie, we start with you. What do you think?
Important. And information.
Why? Why is it important, Rosie? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué sería importante?
No sé cómo decírselo en inglés.
If you want to, I can give you time. Si quiere, le doy un poquito de tiempo para que organice sus ideas.
Okay.
Tell me. Okay. Rafa, and you? What do you think? Why is it important to check your email? Oh, just activate the microphone, Rafa. Sorry, I don't hear you.
Keep Mario need a call.
But in your personal opinion, Rafa, is it important to check the email every day? A opinión personal, ¿lo considera usted importante revisar el email? Do you consider that important?
Yes, it's very important. It's work activity.
You can say principal or main activities. Ah, okay.
Okay.
Do you want to add something else? No sé si quiere agregar algo más. Do you want to add something else?
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Rafa. And Jani? Jani, did you? Sorry, Nelson. Nelson, what about you, Nelson? What do you think?
Excuse me, teacher.
Nelson, is it important to check the email? ¿Cree que es importante? Yes, Rafa.
Mario work, the possibility is work call center or service client.
Sorry, Rafa, se oye raro el micrófono, no entiendo muy bien. se oye como lejos y...
Mario work is service client or call center, for example.
But what is the question? I'm sorry, I don't understand the question.
Por ejemplo, es importante para Mario porque trabaja en un call center o servicio al cliente.
Ah, okay. You can say that it is important for Mario. Okay. Because he works in a call center.
Okay.
That's the way you can say it. Okay. And yes, Nelson, did you think about your answer?
Because same information, the company.
To check the information of the company. Sí. That is true. You have to be there updated. Okay, Nelson, thank you. Hi, Iris, welcome. Nice to see you. Nice to have you. I don't hear you, Iris. I think it's the microphone again. But welcome. Nice to have you over here. Rosy. Okay, hoy sí, ya. Hoy sí, ya escucho, Iris. What is your comment, Rosy?
Bueno, como dijo en lo personal, ¿verdad?
Your personal opinion.
If it is very important to find information from our supervisor and place orders.
Okay, Rosie, thank you. So, guys, we're going to study a little bit. And thank you, Katia, for the message. I read the message. We are going to study how to create emails in English. I'm going to give you some information. I also send it by chat. It's also in the group. But here we have some information about how to create an email. We have some info about how to create an email, the structure in English. And guys, ¿hay alguien aún que no tenga el link para el grupo de WhatsApp? Porque les mando ahí información que vamos a estudiar en la clase. ¿Hay alguien que aún no esté de los que ya están acá? I'm going to send the link again. Voy a enviar acá el link de nuevo. In case you are not there, you just have to click the link. And it will take you there. Okay, so here you have information that you can use when you create an email. Aquí hay información que pueden utilizar cuando creen un email in English. Más adelante vamos a crear, but for now you have some information. This is the first part. Question: how do you start an email properly? Let's imagine that this is your greeting. That's the greeting part. Greeting es el saludo, greeting. So this is that part. estamos hablando de la primera parte que son, que es el greeting, el saludo, greeting. You have different options. There are different options. For example, you can say, dear, dear Yanira Cepeda, and the name, dear, and you mention the name of the person. Can you read that part, Rafa, please? Number one, the information about dear. Just activate the mic.
Okay.
What you see in pink.
It's more appropriate for formal email. Use it when you address a person in a position of respect.
Thank you, Rafa. Okay, so this is a formal, okay, a formal greeting. It's formal. We use dear when you talk about a person with a position of respect. Yes? Are we clear? Good? Dear? Yes. Okay. Now, number two, hi. Hi, and the name. Hi, Iris Cañas. Hi, Daisy. Let's read that one. Can you read it, Jani? Please. Number two.
It's somewhat friendly and direct, but also informal.
Use it carefully.
Use it
carefully.
Carefully.
Yes. Thank you. So hi is informal. It's an informal greeting. Hi. Hi, Nelson. Hi, Rosie. Informal and friendly. Amigable, friendly. But informal and simple. But you can use it. Lo podrían utilizar, pero es informal. And you have this option, greetings. Como que dijéramos saludos, greetings. You have that option too. René, can you read it, please? Where it says greetings.
Greetings. Use it when you don't know the name of the recipient.
In other words,
it's like for someone else that you don't know, so it's just informal greeting.
Exactly. So you have no idea who is receiving your email. No saben quién lo va a recibir. Don't write the name. Just greetings. That could be for anybody. No idea. No sabemos a quién va. Okay. And then you have the next one. Can you read it, Daisy? Please. Hi. Hi, everyone. Hi, guys. The one here. Daisy, just activate the microphone. Can you read the last one, please?
Hi, everyone. Sería guys.
Yes.
This one is when you are emailing a group of people informally.
Informally. Thank you. Thank you, Daisy. Okay, so this one is for a group of people, informal. Informal greeting for your friends or people you know. Ya lo utilizamos con personas que conocemos, ¿verdad? Es de confianza. Okay, questions about the greetings? Do you have questions about this part?
Maybe on greetings, the word that I read, receive it.
Recipient.
Is that correct? How do you pronounce it?
Recipient.
Recipient.
Mm-hmm.
Recipient.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Got it.
All right. Now we have this other part of an email. The reason of the email. you have different options. Here you have different options to start the reason of the email. Okay, so we will read the different options that you have. Rina, can you read number one and two? Point number one and two.
Okay. I am writing to you about your last meeting, your presentation yesterday, your next event. I am writing to you with regard to concerning a connection with.
Yes, okay, Rina, thank you. Que como les menciono, esta es solo una idea de cómo podrían comenzar su razón del email. Okay, do you have questions about the words? I don't know if you have a question about Katia.
Regards.
Con relación. Regards or regarding. But you have two options.
Concerning,
prácticamente lo mismo, en conexión, con relación, is the same, different options. Por eso está con slash.
Okay.
The same. All right. Let's go with the next one. Iris, can you read number three and four, please?
Okay. Do you hear me, teacher?
Yes, now I do.
Okay. I am writing to us and Inquired, let you know, confirm, check, invite you to update you on ask for a favor. I am requiring you to follow up on.
Okay, thank you. For example, this one, guys, to follow up is to continue. That is what it means, to continue, to follow up, to continue something, to follow up. To follow up the problem, to continue the problem, to discuss the problem. And here you have ask and inquire. Ask and inquire is the same. Inquire is more formal. Estas dos son lo mismo, solo que inquire es inquirir, or like that, right? Inquirir or inquirir, que prácticamente is just more formal, but it's the same.
You can. When we are reading an email, if we are inquire, is the same as ask, but like you said, it's more formal.
Okay. Yes, okay. More formal and polite.
And polite. All right.
Yes. And you have different possibilities. I'm writing to let you know. I'm writing to confirm the information. I'm writing to check the information. I'm writing to invite you to a concert, to a party, to a class. I'm writing to update you. Update. Actualizar. Update. And the last one, I'm writing to ask for a favor. Pedir un favor. Okay, you have different options. Questions? Nehemías, Nelson, questions? Yes, no? No, we're fine. Okay, guys, I have to take the attendance. I have to take the attendance again. Please remember to say present. So we start with Daisy Mesquita. Daisy?
Present.
Thank you. Doris de Castaneda, Iris, Joanna?
Present.
Thank you, Jennifer Morales, Jose Mario Cruz, Katia Gabriela.
Present.
Thank you, Marisela del Carmen. Mauricio de Mauricio Castaneda. Nehemías, Regalo.
Present.
Thank you. Minet no está. Nelson Aguirre.
Present.
Thank you. Nelson René. Nelson René Guevara.
Present.
Ah, ok. Es que hay dos Nelson. Está Nelson Alberto Aguirre y Nelson, usted, Nelson Guevara. Ok, let's continue. Un tocayo. And then Rafael Antonio.
Present.
Antonio, thank you. René Guardado.
Present.
Thank you. Rina. Rosy.
No, present, teacher.
Vladimir. Yanira. Jesús López.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much. Okay, so let's continue with the next point. Nehemías, can you please read the next points? The ones we have here. The last ones.
Okay. I am contacting you to inform. I am reaching out because this is just a quick note. This is just a quick reminder.
Quick reminder. Okay. Do you have questions about those phrases? Reminder, it means to remember you, to remember you about something. Like, hey, remember the class, remember the meeting. This is a quick reminder to remember something. Okay, to remember. Anything else? Reaching out? Reaching out is the same as contacting you. Is a phrasal verb, es un phrasal verb, pero significa lo mismo que contacting, que contactar, reaching out. It's the same, it has the same meaning. Okay, questions? If not, we continue with the closing lines. This is the last part, closing lines. You have different phrases that you could use. Katia, can you read the first three, please?
Okay. Looking forward to
hearing.
Mm-hmm. From you soon. I look forward to hearing from
you. From you. Mm-hmm. Soon.
From you soon. Please let me know if this works, if you are
available.
If that sounds good, if you can help, if you need to
reschedule.
Reschedule.
Mm-hmm. ¿Se recuerdan de schedule? Que la practicábamos bastante. Do you remember what it means? Yes, no. Schedule era como horario, pero puede ser verbo también, como programar algo. Pero reschedule es como reprogramar. So that is reschedule. Okay, so please let me know if, así lo comenzarían y luego tienen different options. If you are available, if that sounds good, if you can help. Después de leave, pueden cambiarlo. You can change the options. Do you have questions? Do you know what hear means? Hear is very similar to listen, right? I'm looking forward is like I am excited. I am excited to listen from you. Como que voy a estar encantado de escuchar de ti pronto. So number one and number two are the same. Las primeras dos son prácticamente lo mismo. I look forward or looking forward to hearing from you. Okay. Do you have a question? Is there something you would like to ask? No? Okay, so the last one, guys. The last one, and we will change. We will change the topic and practice. Let's see. Rosie, can you read them, please? The last one.
I look forward to seeing, meeting you. See you Thursday next week. Thanks you in advance for everything.
Okay, thank you. So there you have other options to close your email. Thank you for everything, or thank you in advance. Like before they do it, you thank them because of the help. See you on Monday, Tuesday, different possibilities. And look forward is the same. Look forward es el mismo que aparece acá. Solo que seeing you ya sería en, no en escucharte, sino en conocerse o verse. Okay, so those are options you can use. Those are some options of phrases you can use. Do you have questions about the structure of the emails? No. Okay, so let's continue, guys. We will remember a little bit about simple present because we're going to practice simple present. So let's see, vamos a ver si todavía se acuerdan. Katia, okay, Katia. When do we use simple present? When do we use simple present? What do we express with simple present? Or Nelson, Iris, maybe they can help you, Nehemias. When do we use simple present? What do you remember?
Cuando con las actividades, me acuerdo, pero no sé si era esa.
Something like that. Activities. But maybe a little bit more specific. I need something a little bit more specific. No. Or maybe René, Rafael, Daisy, do you know? When do you use simple present? When should we use it? ¿Cuándo es que utilizamos simple present? Who remembers?
If I don't get promise, like when an action is happening?
Well, not really, because it will be present continuous when it's happening.
Okay.
But thank you, René, for your comment. Well, I will help you in that case. Here you have it, guys. René, can you read it, please?
Sure. We use the present simple to talk about things we do all of the time. Habits, traditions, regular activities. A structure S plus B plus C.
Sorry, I have to go and plug in the charger. if not, it was going to be turned off, my computer.
Oh, okay.
Thank you, René. So here, guys, you have when you should use simple present, okay, to talk about regular activities, to talk about habits or traditions. Now we have, to say it like that, we have two versions of simple present. Teníamos como dos versiones prácticamente de simple present, de la structure, right? Ahí estaba una, the one that René just read. Subject, verb, and complement. Let me show you something. Okay, so let's see this. Let me, okay. So we have this, simple present. And let's imagine that this is the group number one. Group number one, plural nouns. And we use do with this group. You have plural nouns and plural subjects. You, they, we, and I. Con todo este grupo que está acá, es que utilizábamos do, right? You, they, we, and I. For example, give me one second. Group number one. Group one, the structure or formula, subject, verb, and complement. That is the group. And this is when you have I, you, we, they, and plural nouns. That is when you use this formula or structure to express regular activities. I go to bed, or let me change it. I watch TV every night. Okay, here you have the structure. Or we study English in the week. One more example, a regular activity or a habit. They drink coffee in the afternoons. Okay, so we have to check the structure. Let's see. Okay, Rina, sentence number one, Rina. I watch TV every night. What is the subject, Rina? What is the subject of the sentence?
I.
Uh-huh, correct. So here we have the first part, right? I. And then, Iris, what is the verb of the sentence?
What?
Uh-huh, watch. So here we have the verb. And then the complement, Janik. What is the complement of the sentence? What is the complement? No, the complement.
Complement.
Uh-huh.
They.
But in the first one, en la primera oración, Jani, ¿cuál sería el complemento? Ya tenemos el sujeto, I, el verbo, watch, And the complement?
Plurals now.
Sería este, Jani. Este es el complement.
Ah, every night.
TV every night. Ese es el complement. Lo que va luego del verbo, that is the complement. ¿Sí?
Ok.
¿Ves? Okay. Yes. Entonces ahí tenemos la estructura, pero ya en palabras, ya con acciones. I watch TV every night. And the same on the next one. So, for example, Rosie, what is the subject? What is the subject of the sentence?
We.
Uh-huh. And what is the verb? Nelson.
Study.
Study, right? The one we have here. And the complement, Katia?
Sería English in the week.
Ajá, sería eso. English in the week. Okay, so we have the structure. Remember, this is group number one. Do, we use do. If you want to make it negative, remember to use don't. I don't watch movies every day. Okay, negative form. We don't study English in the morning. Right? Or they don't drink tea with me. Okay, this is the group number one. This is the one of the versions, right? Okay. Ese es un recordatorio de lo que veíamos en el módulo pasado para que recordemos la estructura, the structure. Okay. Is there something you would like to ask? No sé si quisieran preguntar algo. Algo que se les haya olvidado, o que no se recuerdan bien, about this group. ¿No? Okay, I will show you group number two. Let me just find the information. Let me see. Okay, group number two, or version number two of simple present. What is the difference? Esta sería como la otra versión, ¿verdad? De la estructura. The formula, subject, verb, plus S, and the complement. En esta otra versión es en la que le ponemos la S al verbo. Ok, when? When do we do it? René, ¿cuándo le agregamos la S al verbo? When do we add the S? And it's here too.
With the verb, let me remember that.
It's here. I will highlight it.
Singular noun, a doctor, a teacher. Oh, the S is like, singular noun. No, but that is the subject. Okay, a doctor.
Is a subject because you can use the noun. Es un noun. Se toma como sujeto, right? Pero estamos utilizando justamente el nombre. A doctor.
Okay.
Or you can use the subject. Because a doctor can be also equal to he. If it is a man, it could be he. Or she. Así que es lo mismo, ¿verdad? Right. Solo que we use the name of the person or the title in this case.
The title, that's right.
Yes. Okay, so you can use singular nouns or he, she, and it. Okay, this is version number two. Esta es la otra versión de simple present. ¿Dónde le agregamos la S? a todo lo singular, ¿okay? Excepto por I, ¿verdad? Porque ese dijimos que aunque es uno, va en la otra versión, en el de do. Okay, here you have examples. Affirmative sentences and negative sentences. Let's see. Okay, Nehemias, can you read the affirmative sentences?
My mom likes pizza. Mm-hmm. Wendy works in a university. Her dog.
Dog.
Her dog sleep with her.
Thank you. Entonces, donde ven la estrella, where you see the star, ahí ya vemos el cambio, ¿verdad? En la oración, the S. Como mencionó Nehemías, likes, works, her dog. No siempre tenemos el sujeto, a veces tenemos el noun, pero como es uno, tenemos que poner la S. Okay? And then you have the opposite side. Tienen la manera negativa. Can you read those ones? Katia, please. Negative sentences.
Okay. My mom doesn't like pupusas.
Mm-hmm.
Wendy doesn't work in a clinic.
Mm-hmm.
Her dog doesn't sleep in the kitchen.
Thank you. So this is group number two, does. Este es el grupo does, right? Donde utilizamos does. Para the negative form es does not or doesn't, que es lo mismo, solo que la contraction. Y no sé si vieron el verbo, ¿verdad? Recuerden el verbo, ya no ponemos la S. We remove the S. We eliminate the S when it's a negative statement. Okay, este es un recordatorio, it's a reminder, okay, de lo que vimos in the last level, okay. Espero que les haya recordado, les haya traído recuerdos. So we're ready, right? Ya estamos listos para practicar. Do you have a question? No sé si quieren preguntar algo. Is there something you would like to ask? No. Okay, guys. So we're going to work in pairs. We're going to work in pairs. And this is the activity that we will do. We're going to practice simple present. Let me see. Okay. Over here you have the instruction of the activity. You have to create 10 sentences, affirmative and negative sentences, 5 and 5. Okay, the total of sentences will be 10 about your classmates. For example, let's imagine that Nehemias is working with Nelson. Nehemias is going to write 10 sentences about Nelson. And Nelson is going to write 10 sentences about Nehemias. Okay? And when you finish, take turns to read out each sentence. I'm sorry. If the information is correct, tell your classmate the information is correct. If not, correct the information. Okay, the translation. Van a ser 10, alrededor de 10 oraciones sobre su compañero con el que van a estar trabajando. Ahora, tienen que más o menos tratar de pensar qué actividades hace su compañero. Como que yo empiece a evaluar a Yanni y voy a escribir, la veo y escribo sobre ella. Escribo. About her life. Y luego le voy a leer las oraciones a Yanni. Por ejemplo, yo le puedo decir, Yanni, you don't have a pet. You don't have a pet. Cuando se la lea, ella me va a corregir o me va a decir si yo estoy en lo correcto o no. Yanni, in your case, ¿tiene mascota?
Yes, two.
Ajá, Ok, entonces ahí me va a decir, I have two pets. Me va a corregir mi statement. Do you understand the activity? ¿Me entienden lo que van a estar haciendo? Yes. Do you have a question?
So it's like, I'm going to start to just reading down 10 sentences about my partner. And mm-hmm. then after that, I will ask him if they are correct. If it's done, if it's not, I need you to like,
he will correct you in the moment of speaking. After you read it, he can correct you. After
so I can be like, I tell you some, or I ask him something, and he tell me is it true or it's not.
Uh-huh.
Then I read it down, and then he asked me something, and go.
Don't correct it. Don't correct it. Just listen to the correction of your classmate, but you okay. don't have to correct it. And take turns, one and one.
One.
Okay. And I will go there, visit you. Yo los visito y yo los escucho. Okay, I will listen to you. Okay, let's see. Okay, so in this case, let's do it like this. Okay, Rosie, you are going to work with Katia. Okay, Rosie and Katia. Daisy, please work with Iris. Please work with Iris. And then Nehemiah work with Rafael. Then Nelson and Gianni, Rosie and Rene. Okay, please open the room and I'll visit you there. Hi, I'm here. I'm visiting you. You're creating the sentences in this moment, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. How many do you have? How many sentences do you have in this moment?
Yo tengo solo dos.
Okay, maybe because of the time, quizás por el tiempo, create like seven or six. Seven or six,
okay.
Because we still have other activities to do. Do you need help? Okay. Do you need help or do you have questions?
¿Verdad que estas son las oraciones acerca de lo que imaginamos que ella hace?
Okay. Correct. Va a asumir. Asumir, okay. Y luego ya Katia le va a corroborar si sí es así, okay. O si no, ella le va a decir cómo es la cosa realmente.
Ok.
All right, so in that case, I'm going to let you. Les voy a dejar que prosigan. See you in a moment. Sí. Bye.
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 Hello. Hey, I wanted to let you know that because of the time, just create like six or seven sentences. Because we have short time before we go and we still have other activities to do. Okay, so maybe just like six or seven sentences. And Daisy, today we have the private session with you. Tengo acá en mi programa que me toca con usted la sesión de 10 minutos. Va a ser posible quedarse.
¿Sí?
Ok, perfecto. Entonces ahí se recuerda. No se me vaya a ir la clase.
Okay.
And Iris, ¿tú prefieres que te llame Joana? Yo estaba viendo en el grupo que así. I prefer Joana.
Joana.
Okay. Más vale tarde que nunca. Okay. So, do you have a question?
Solo sentences or question?
No, no questions. Porque, sorry, Daisy. Porque vamos a asumir que lo que imaginas que Daisy hace. Entonces, tú haces la oración y ya Daisy va a decirte si es así o si no.
Okay.
Okay, but just like six or seven. So, porque creo que tipo 9:40 vamos a regresar. Así que traten de terminar before the time is over. All right, so I'm going to let you continue. See you in a moment. Bye. Hi. How are you doing, guys? How many sentences do you have in this moment?
Seven.
Like seven. And you, Naomi?
Six.
Like six. Ah, okay. So almost the same. Okay, that this activity is going to help you to know each other a little bit more. Les va a ayudar a conocerse un poquito más. Asumir. Yeah. Okay, and do you need help? Recuerden de combinar negativas y afirmativas. So you can use do and does.
Oh, okay.
And, okay. Sorry.
No, negativas.
Y affirmatives.
Okay.
O pueden hacerlo sobre otra persona. Maybe your mom doesn't like to go to the beach. Okay, oh. Pueden hacerlas así, ¿verdad? About somebody else there. Guys, we will be going back around 9:38, alrededor de esa hora, 9:38, 9:39, we will be back. Si terminan antes, please let me know. En caso que terminen antes que los demás.
Okay.
Do you have questions before I let you continue?
No questions.
No questions.
Okay, Rafa, ya estás en el grupo de WhatsApp.
Sí.
Yeah, okay, thank you. I'm just checking. All right, so I'll see you later, guys. Bye.
Talk to.
Sorry to interrupt.
I go to the morning. Yes, Celia. Yes, I go to the morning.
How are you doing? ¿Qué tal van por acá?
Ya van avanzando.
¿Y cómo se sienten volver otra vez a practicar inglés? ¿No sienten como eso de volverlo a refrescar?
Sí.
Exacto, sí. Después de 2 semanas.
Ajá.
Sí.
Se siente.
Estamos como que fue. Como que estuviéramos en la primera.
Ok, pero ahora, no sé si han notado, he utilizado un poquito más de inglés. ¿Cómo han sentido? ¿Van entendiendo la mayoría? ¿Cómo se han sentido?
¿Yani?
Bueno, yo me he sentido bien, solo que hay veces como que me da nerviosito porque no, esa palabra, como es.
No, y también creo que
como... del Google.
No, y también creo que como el grupo ahorita está un poco distinto, entonces tienen que esperar, ir agarrando confianza con los nuevos, ¿verdad? Por decirlo
con
así.
Con los nuevos, sí. Uh-huh.
Entonces,
pero me gusta que estemos los compañeros anteriores, o sea, ya ahí está como...
No, y falta Mario, falta Minet, uh-huh. falta Marisela, faltan varios, pero están enfermos, están enfermos la mayoría.
Están en el grupo.
No todos, pero sí, ya mañana dicen que ya se van a unir. Ajá, pero sí, estos días van a ser como de regresar al inglés.
Sí.
Estas actividades uh-huh. les van a ayudar a recordar, a volver a sacar todo lo que estuvimos estudiando.
Sí, okay. sí. Primero Dios, ahí vamos. Ahí estoy auxiliándome de mis apuntes.
Ok, good. Está bien. Ok, no sé si tienen alguna pregunta para mí antes que me marche y los deje seguir.
Bueno, en el caso nosotros habíamos entendido, no sé si me equivoco, igual Jani me corrige ahí, de que íbamos a hacer oraciones, podrían ser afirmativas, y en cuál la otra persona iba a confirmar o
ajá,
a
negar,
corregir, digamos, o a negar ajá, la oración que estuviera diciendo el otro.
Correcto, como que yo le digo... You live in Santa Ana. Es una afirmación, pero usted me va a decir, no, I live in, y ya me menciona el lugar. O sea, yo voy a decir lo que asumo sobre usted, pero ya usted va a decirme si yo estoy en lo correcto o me dice cómo está la cosa realmente.
Ajá.
Ok. Perfecto.
Pero sí, entendimos bien.
Ah, pues sí. ¿Cuántas llevan? ¿Cuántas sentences llevan?
Dos, pero porque estábamos como sí, afirmativas o negativas, pero ahorita ya con su, con lo que nos acaba de decir, ya vamos a meterle ahorita.
Okay, all right. I'm going to let you continue. In that case, see you in a moment. Okay. Bye.
Okay. Lo que yo le estoy diciendo.
Gramática, exacto.
Hi,
gramática
guys.
Es lo que siento que me cuesta.
How are you doing?
Not that not bad, but
okay.
We are still working on that. We have just a couple of questions about
uh-huh.
it. First of all, I'm trying to find the manual and I didn't find it. It is possible that you can share that on the WhatsApp group?
Yes, I can do that. I can send it to you over there. I was about to ask that. So you are already in the group, right, René?
Yes.
And you, Rosy, ya se agregó al grupo?
Sí.
Yes. Sí, ¿verdad? Ustedes del principio. Okay. All right. Perfect. Sí, ya vi aquí, René. Ya le vi la cara. Ya sé quién está atrás. Okay, good. Right. So, do you have other questions? René quiere que le envíe ahorita él.
Yes, please. Pretty much we are trying to create the words or create the sentences. And maybe when we are trying to ask between us if it's correct or not, we have maybe we are not sure how to express that. For example, if I say Rosie works as a nurse, is mm-hmm. this the correct way to say it?
Uh-huh. And then she will say, no, I
she,
work
she say, I not
uh-huh
so,
no.
So in that case I need to read it down what she has. Answer me about the question. So I
no, you don't need to write it. Just listen to her.
Okay. Uh-huh. Okay. Oh. Okay. Okay.
Right.
So it's like I just need to ask her, and she is gonna tell me if it's not if it's correct or it's not.
Uh-huh. She just
try to do
correct.
Okay.
All right. Okay. But maybe because of the time, we will go back in a few minutes. So try to start now so you can practice a little bit more. Okay. Okay. Well, you're going to get that on the group, Rene, in a moment. I think it's there now. Yes. Okay. All right, guys. So I'll see you in a moment. Okay. Bye.
Okay. Bye.
Yes.
Oh, he doesn't pet.
Doesn't have.
Yes, I have one dog and two cats.
Okay. Finish.
You finish. Ya vine tarde. Yes. Sorry.
Bueno, él le falta que me pregunte.
Pues no tan tarde. Ok, Nehemías. Continúo. Okay. Antes que continúe, Nehemías. Rafa, can you read the last one? ¿Puede leer la del pet one more time?
He has doesn't pet.
Ok, thank you. En esa es para él, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Y solo una pregunta, ¿por qué ha utilizado el he?
¿Cómo me estoy refiriendo a él o tendría que usar you?
Ajá, sí, por eso, porque va directamente para Nehemías.
Ya.
Ajá, utiliza el he cuando está hablando como que hable conmigo de él.
Tercera.
Pero ajá. Si es directamente para Nehemías, you y ya utilice don't, ya no das.
Okay.
You don't. Tiene una foto de sus oraciones que la pueda mandar al grupo. Quisiera verlas, las otras.
Rafa. Lo que sucede es que igual las utilicé porque pensé que era como que iba a decirle a usted lo que él. Sí, no lo tomé como que yo le preguntaba a él, sino que le iba a decir a usted.
Entonces sí. ya aclaramos eso. Okay, Nehemías, sí. Continue that case.
Bueno, entonces lo voy a cambiar.
Yes, later, Rafa. Okay. Nehemías, continue. Gracias. I will listen to you a moment. Oh, the microphone name is.
Yes, sorry. Rafael live in San Salvador?
No, I live in Huachapan.
Okay. You play soccer on weekend?
No plays.
Okay. Rafael works in a bank?
No, I work in hardware store.
Okay.
Nehemiah, sorry to interrupt you. Rafa, you can use that short answer to say no. You can also say no, I don't. That is the short way to say it. Okay.
No. Answer short. No, I don't. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes, I do.
Yes, I do. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. You get up early every day?
Yes, I do.
Mm-hmm. You watch TV on the night?
Yes, I do.
Doesn't walk to work?
You don't.
You doesn't walk to work?
You don't walk.
Don't. Okay, don't. You work don't today. Walk to work?
No, I don't.
Your mother doesn't like bread?
like
bread.
Bread.
Pan.
In Spanish.
Pan.
Pan. Bread. Pan. 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 Uh-huh. Okay. Yes.
She does.
She.
Ajá, estuvimos en otro grupo. Bueno, verlo.
Hi. Hi, Rina.
Hi, Rafa. Rafael también estuvo con nosotros.
Do you know each other? Estaban en otro grupo de inglés acá, ¿o cómo?
Sí, sí, en el
primer módulo.
En el primer módulo.
Ah, ok. All right.
Yo creo que solo los cuatro, Daisy, Rafa.
Ah, okay.
It is true, Daisy. He was there.
Okay, got it.
Hi, René.
Hello.
Okay, interesting.
Teacher, I have a question about the manual. Porque se nos hace más fácil a veces tener la información impresa. El manual va a ser algo que usted va a ocupar en su metodología para las clases, o sea, si va a valer la pena que lo podamos imprimir o en algún dado caso no.
Yes, do it. I use it a lot.
Perfecto.
So, yeah, try to.
Okay.
Not maybe all the pages, but most of them, yes. Yes, I use the book a lot. We will use it right now. Again.
Teacher.
Yes.
Teacher. Una consulta. En el grupo anterior. Usted nos mandó el manual a WhatsApp, porque hay veces da problema plataforma y todo eso, y ahora quise entrar yo, porque yo tengo instalada, me ayudaron, y tengo instalada la plataforma en uno de los celulares, que es donde me apoyo, pero ahorita entré y no tengo la plataforma de este curso número 2, no pude entrar, entonces no sé si usted tiene la accesibilidad de poderlos enviar por WhatsApp.
The books.
Ajá, el libro.
I just sent it. Lo mandé hace como unos 10 minutos, maybe, hace como 10 minutos. Los acabo de enviar. Bueno, lo acabo de enviar. Ahí está otra vez, Jenny. Entonces, ahorita ya todos están en el grupo, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Ahorita sí todos estamos ahí.
Sí.
Ok, perfecto.
Ya lo vi. Gracias. Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. So, guys, we have one more exercise, maybe because of the time to go. We will complete the sentences that we have here. And remember, we have to use sometimes the S, and sometimes we only need to use you have here the verbs. You have the verbs, and you have to choose the right one. Okay, let's see. Let's start with Joanna. Okay, Joanna, help me with number 2. Our secretary. And then she sends them via email. Or guys, do you want me to give you time? Estoy unos 2 minutitos para que las lean. And then we do it together. Okay. All right, go ahead.
¿Podría decir yo?
Yes, Katia.
Tal vez sería write a report.
Read a report.
Porque después lo tiene que enviar por vía email.
She sends them via email. Write or read. Both, I think, depending on the way you see it, maybe write or maybe read. I will use write. And I have to use the S, write a report, and then she sends them by email. Okay, thank you. Let's see in that case, number three. What do you think about that one, Daisy? I
read a report.
Mm-hmm. I read a report. Let's see. I read a report twice a day. I use my laptop computer. Any other possibility?
I think that is check my email.
I check my email twice a day. Mm-hmm. That one sounds better. Sounds better. So let's choose that one. I read my email. But thank you, Daisy. Okay, next one. What do you think about that one, Nelson? Number four. I have to.
No.
Okay, that's it. All right. That's an idea. A possibility. Number four. What could we use? I have to every Monday.
Attend a meeting.
Uh-huh, that's one possibility. This one is another possibility, number eight. But yes, I have to attend a meeting. That's the best choice. Okay, thank you. And now, Nehemias, what do you think about number five?
Attend a meeting.
Celia.
Sí, Celia, attend a meeting.
Uh-huh. And I'm going to add the end. Attend a meeting. Attend a meeting. The meeting takes place in the auditorium. Uh-huh. Okay, sounds good. Do you guys have questions? Something that you would like to ask? No? All right, in that case, I'm going to take the attendance one last time before we go. And in the group, I'm going to send the list for the private sessions. Voy a enviar ahí en el grupo el día de mañana. El orden para, como el calendario, para que ustedes sepan qué día les toca su sesión. Y si no, en caso que quizás el que le toque no esté, entonces pues vamos a seguir con el que, vamos a como cambiar, ¿verdad? A cambiar para que pase el siguiente en ese caso. Ok, so we start with Daisy Yesenia.
Present.
Thank you. Doris Guevara. Then Iris Joanna.
Present.
Thank you. Jennifer Marcela. Jose Mario. Katia Gabriela.
Present.
Thank you. Lisette del Carmen Pineda. No. Marisela del Carmen. Mauricio Rodolfo. Ninette Rivera, Nehemías Regalo.
Present.
Thank you. Nelson Alberto. Nelson René Guevara.
Present.
Thank you. Rafael Antonio.
Present.
René Guardado.
Present.
Rina, thank you. Rina Espinosa.
Present.
Thank you. Vladimir, Vladimir Antonio, no, Yanira Cepeda.
Present.
Thank you. And Zulma, Zulma Lorena. Okay, she's not there. So, guys, los que mencioné también estaban con ustedes, con Rosy, Rafa. Los que no están, que mencioné, también estaban en su grupo.
Es Zulma, no. Me recuerdo yo.
Zulma, sí.
Zulma, bueno, y Esenia.
Ajá, ella sí. De los Zulma, demás, no.
De Zulma, no me.
The other ones, no.
No, no me recuerdo de otra.
Ah, ok.
Que haya mencionado ahorita, no.
Ajá, ok. Bueno, mañana. Mañana probablemente.
A ver, ¿qué tal mañana?
Sí, algunos ojalá. Me escribieron que estaban enfermos, que se pusieron la vacuna y tienen dolores. Así sí, que sí. Mañana, porque sí, casi la mitad faltó, porque son 20 y hay 10.
Sí.
Así que mañana creo que sí ya vamos a estar más, más completos. But yes, do you have questions or comments? That you... Something that you may need? No, no questions. Okay, excellent.
No questions.
Well, tomorrow we will continue practicing. Because ya ven que luego de pasar un tiempito sin practicarlo, se siente uno raro, ¿verdad? Es raro volver a comenzar. But yeah,
pasamos inactivos casi un mes.
Ajá, fue un tiempo algo largo. ¿Desde cuándo terminaron su curso anterior?
¿Ustedes? Yo pensé que no lo había probado el primer módulo. Sí.
Ah, ah, okay.
Ya no me llamaron.
Ah, so you were waiting. Sí, bueno, también mi grupo que está aquí casi todos, también fueron como más de 15 días quizás, ¿verdad?
Sí, ah, wow. 2 semanas.
Uh-huh. ¿Sí? Desde la vacación, ¿sí? Que salieron uh-huh. como en el 1
antes
de agosto.
De la vacación.
¿Sí?
Nosotros el 15 de julio fue la última clase.
Ah, ok, oh, sí. No. Ah, pues sí. Ya tenía un poco más. Ok, entonces, ajá, estas primeras clases van a ir sintiendo como que van recordando y agarrando y agarrando y agarrando ideas. Ya creo que ya para tipo miércoles, jueves, ya van a estar otra vez ya. Ya, cabal. Okay, cool. So we will wait just a few seconds, guys. Solo vamos a esperar unos segundos y luego nos quedamos con Daisy. Daisy, we will continue with you. Okay, now you are free to go, guys. Nice to see you again. And nice to meet you guys, the new ones. Nice to have you over here. See you tomorrow. Sweet dreams.
Tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Good evening.
Bye. We will wait just a moment, Daisy, just for your classmates to go, and then we continue with you. Okay, Daisy, nice to meet you. How are you? ¿Qué tal se sintió, Daisy?
Bien.
A veces el primer día se siente uno más tímido, ¿verdad? Va comenzando. Nuevas. Y lo de que había pasado un tiempo también sin estudiar, todo eso afecta el primer día.
Sí, pero la verdad.
Ajá, el grupo con el que está es bien amigable, solo que ellos también se sienten ahorita como el primer día, ¿verdad? Como hay nuevos, diferentes, nuevas caras, así que eso poco a poco se van conociendo y van mejorando.
Sí, era grande.
So, yes. So, Daisy... ¿En qué cosa del inglés le puedo ayudar? ¿Cuál siente que es como su punto débil? ¿O le cuesta más entender? Cuénteme.
Fíjese que, o sea, más que todo, lo que me falta es así vocabulario.
Mm-hmm.
Porque a veces, o sea, de escuchar sí entiendo algunas cosas, mm-hmm. pero ya a la hora de hablarlo es como que ya me cuesta.
Hablarlo.
Ajá, así como hacer oraciones.
Ah, ok, you're right. ¿Y cómo sintió el repaso de Simple Present? ¿Sí entendió bien cómo se hacían los cambios y todo?
Sí.
Ok, ¿qué le gustaría practicar ahorita que tenemos tiempo? Quisiera que tratáramos de hacer una conversation in English, platicar en inglés. Quiere que le explique algún tema, quiere que leamos. What would you like me to do, Daisy?
Leer.
Read. Okay, let's do it with this. I have something here. Aquí tengo un reading que podemos utilizar. Let me just get it here. One moment. I'm going to read first and then you continue. Okay, then you continue. Okay. It's loading. Solo estoy esperando acá aquí que cargue. Okay, now I have it here. Okay, Daisy, so I'm going to start first. De hecho, es algo que vamos a usar mañana, pero no todos lo van a leer, así que podemos practicar con usted. Okay, so we will start with this. Okay, that part. It says, I will say it first and then you repeat. Okay, voy a leerlo yo todo y luego usted, Daisy. It says, so Garrett, what's your daily routine like? My routine is actually a little irregular. I have a different working schedule for each day of the week. But on a weekend, my son usually wakes me up about 8, 9 o'clock. And after that, we go downstairs and I get him some cereal, like he likes at the moment, chocolate rice Krispies. And he has a bowl of them, and we watch Toy Story. He loves Buzz and Woody. Okay, Daisy, now it's your turn.
Okay. So, Garrett, what's your daily routine like? My routine is actually a little irregular. I have a different working
schedule
for each day of the week, but on a weekend my son usually wakes me up about 8, 9 o'clock, and after that we go
down, como que fuera a Daisy.
Okay, downstairs.
Ajá, yes.
Downstairs. And I greet him some cereal, like he likes at the moment, chocolate rice Krispies, and he has a bowl of them, and we watch Toy Story. He loves Buzz and Woody.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. Good pronunciation. No, now part number two. Every weekend, the same movie? Exactly. Again and again and again. Yeah, so we watch it a lot on weekdays, though I usually wake up at 6 a.m. I have to go to work at 8. So I commute on the bus and train, and that takes an hour and a half. It takes a long time. And then I work. I get home about 7. I have dinner with my wife. Usually, if I come home late, she waits and she'll have dinner with me. And sometimes she'll wait until like 9. Okay, Daisy.
Okay. Every weekend there is some movie. Exactly. Again and again and again.
Sorry, yeah. Daisy, to interrupt you. This one, same.
Same.
Again. Aquí como que solo va a ser un sonido. Again.
Again.
Ajá.
Exactly again and again and again.
Yes.
Yeah. So we watch it a lot. On weekdays, how?
I do. Do.
Do. Do.
Mm-hmm.
I usually wake up at 6 a.m. I have to go to work at 8. So I commute on the bus and train, and that takes an hour and a half. It takes a long time. And they at work, I get home about 7. I have dinner with my wife. Usually, if I come home late, she waits and she'll have dinner with me. And sometimes she'll wait until like 9.
Okay, well, very good pronunciation, Daisy. Siento que tiene bastante buena pronunciación. No siento que le cueste tanto. Solo esas que le mencionaba, por ejemplo, same, again, schedule, que es una que casi a todos les cuesta porque se escribe totalmente diferente, como se dice, schedule. Pero ajá, voy a tratar de mantener siempre varios readings para que eso les dé más pronunciación en vocabulario.
Sí, ajá, sí, porque, o sea, practicando así es como que la lengua se va a desarrollar.
Ajá, a veces les pongo tongue twisters también, trabalenguas en inglés. Uh-huh. Hicieron en el módulo pasado.
Sí.
Ajá, esos también sirven.
Ajá, también sí, sirven para poder
desenvolver la lengua. Ajá. Sí. Okay, Daisy, I think we will stop here. But tomorrow we continue, okay? We continue practicing. Is there something else I can help you with? No sé si había alguna duda antes que cerrara la sesión.
No.
Estamos bien.
Por el momento, sí.
Okay, cualquier cosa, pues ahí me escribes, Daisy. I'm going to close the session. Good night. Sweet dreams.
Good night.
Bye.